So thank you, Mohan, for splendid opening remarks or setting the tone. And if there was anything left to wake you up, guys, I mean, I know Vineet does a great job. So let's again give a big hand to Vineet and Mohan. So, guys, look at two distinct themes that Mohan and Vineet spoke about. Mohan's point, by giving EV examples or the energy examples, were fundamentally to demonstrate that whatever is part of our lives today, that will also change. The reality of his giving us an example of UK, where UK is known as a country where you discuss weather more because their weather is the ever-changing weather, whether it is going to rain today or not, whether it's going to be sunny today or not. And think of that, the opportunity that countries like India have, and why are we discussing coal, and why are we not discussing microgrids in our communities the way Calcutta did it once when they pooled their resources together and had a gen set for a particular locality or a community. So the point here was really that if you exercise your imagination, if you take into account the resources that are available to you, and if you start plotting for future, you will realize that industry is not disrupting. We are evolving. We are changing this industry because we are learning to use or connect data a lot better. It is not only about IT. It is about using various tools that are available to us, whether you call them technology or whether you call them God's resources like sun. But the point here again is that if we connect the dots right, we are the people who are evolving. We will drive that change. It is not that book, "Who Moved My Cheese?" We will move the cheese. The second point that Vineet has elaborated is that if you are not relevant, don't blame the industry. Don't blame the technology. It's our job to be relevant. And if we are relevant, then we are harnessing the biggest resource that any country, any organization, any firm, or any community has, which is the people energy. And my request now is go back. Go back and think of all the beautiful words that are being spoken today, whether they are called mobility, whether they are called IoT, whether they are called cloud. The technology behind them have existed for more than 30 years. IoT is nothing but a sensor being applied at various points. And earlier we used to have instrumentation, process and controls. We used to do it only in a refinery. We used to do it only in a chemical plant. Now we have started saying, the stethoscope that I used on a body, why can't I use it on an electric pump and actually from the audiometry be able to determine when that electric pump will fail. Again, we are connecting the dots a lot better because the technology has now risen exponentially and it has also fallen in prices exponentially. Think about it. Is it not evolution that we used to read newspapers? Then we started going on the internet. Then we started going on our mobile phones. We started going on apps, and today, if you are a user of Alexa or a Siri, you can actually curate your Alexa to read the news to you in the morning. And I'm using the word curate. You can decide whether you want to listen to Virat Kohli's double century or you want to listen to a fashion parade in Paris. The news can be curated and it will be read to you while you're brushing your teeth, and it is happening today. It is happening in homes today. Now, how many of us are evolving ourselves faster than the others? If we are not evolving, how will we allow our organizations to evolve? So to me, the only message that I have is technology is not new. Only change that has happened is now the change is exponential. Number two is nothing called science fiction. Anything that you think is fiction is now reality. And number three is if we are the ones who will drive the change, then I promise you, automation creates more jobs today than what it created in the past. That, if you are talking about mixed reality, it opens up new businesses than it were created in the past. If you are talking about quantum computing, it will open up more applications than we have ever had in the past. It is for us to evolve and forget it is disruption. It is how do we remain relevant? How do we make our organizations, our people relevant? So I'm going to take a pause here, and I'm sure there will be more interesting conversations as we go along during the day.